What is the reason for people using of a hair dye? It is basically to change the natural color of your hair. As I was telling you, we human beings are very, typical. Whatever naturally has been obtained to us, we are not going to use that. Okay, so we have black color. We are going to change it to say brown, blue, white, green, red, whatever you want. Okay. Whereas some in other countries, they have those red color, they change it to black color. Okay. So whatever we are having, we don't want it. We want to change whatever is the natural color of your hair. And hence, in order to change the natural color of your hair, you're going to use hair dyes. Okay. So you have black hair, you convert it into red, blue, yellow, white, whatever you want. Okay. Silver, golden. So these color you try to change it. There is one more reason why you are using hair dye, whereby you use permanent hair dye, because your colors have become gray. Okay, once your colors become gray, then that is a sign of old, their oldness, isn't it? And each and every person wants to look young, isn't it? So what we are doing is we are using hair dyes. So those gray hair, they are converted into black hair with the help of the permanent hair dyes. So that is another reason. One is to change the natural color of your hair. Second is to color the gray hair and make it black so that you look younger. Black hair usually gives a feeling of youngness. Okay. So and gray hair is a symbol of oldness. So in order to look young, you change your gray hair to black hair. And also to change the hair color temporarily for a particular occasion. You are going for a party, okay? You are going for a marriage, and hence you want to apply some color to it so that the there is some change in the color for that particular occasion, okay? So these are the reasons why you go for the hair dyes, okay? In order to change the hair color, basically, in order to look beautiful, in order to look different than what you are always looking, okay? Now, what are the ideal characteristics that are required from your hair color? Basically, your color should be changed, but the gloss should remain as such of your hair. Then, the texture of the hair should not be changed. Next thing, very important, is it should not hurt your hair shaft. That is a very important aspect, because if it injures your hair shaft, then your hair are going to become weak and they are going to get fall off. They are going to get removed. So that should not happen. So it should not change the texture of the color. It should have that natural gloss. Okay. It should not hurt your hair shaft. It should be non-irritant, and it should be free from sensitizing also. It should not give that irritation kind of a feeling to your hair or your scalp. Okay. Then it should not have any toxicity effect. Many a times your ammonia dyes and the coal tar colors, if they are used, then these hair dyes, they have toxicity. So they should not have toxicity. They should not have systemic toxicity. Okay, they should remain stable for a longer period of time, for the time that is intended. You have temporary hair dyes, which can be removed in one wash. You have semi-temporary hair dyes, which are removed after a week. And you have permanent hair dye. So whatever is the requirement from the hair dye, for that much time it should remain stable. It should not get removed. Okay. Then there should not be any effect of shampoo, okay, setting lotion, etc., on your dyed hair. And finally, it should be stable when it is being used. Okay. So these are the different characteristics that are required from your hair dye. Now, let us move further to the types of hair dye. Okay. Now, basically, the hair dyes are divided into two parts. You have oxidative hair dyes and you have non-oxidative hair dyes. Okay. Now, oxidative hair dyes are the hair dyes whereby oxidation reaction is taking place. Okay. Oxidation reaction is taking place. And the color formation is whatever the dye has been obtained, that dye is applied to your hair. Those are oxidative hair dyes. Basically, the permanent hair dyes, okay, they fall under this category. Whereas you have non-oxidative hair dyes, whereby oxidation reaction does not take place. It is just a normal color. No reaction is taking place between the ingredients that you are adding. Okay, so there is no reaction that is taking place. No oxidation reaction is taking place, and then they are added to you. Then they are applied to your oxidative reaction in what? In between the ingredients that you have added. So you have ingredient number one and you have ingredient number two. When an oxidation reaction takes place, okay, inside it, those type of reaction, and when the color formation happens, okay, a dye has been prepared and that dye is applied to your hair, those are known as oxidative hair dyes. When this reaction does not take place between the ingredients that you have added inside the formulation, then these are known as non-oxidative hair dyes. Basically, the temporary, the semi-permanent, and the demi-permanent hair dyes, they basically come in the category of your non-oxidative. So your hair dyes are divided into two categories. They can be divided as oxidative and non-oxidative. Okay, accordingly, okay, they can be further classified as temporary, semi-permanent, demi-permanent, and permanent. Moving ahead with our first hair dyeing system, that is temporary non-oxidative hair dyeing system. Okay, as I told you, basically whenever the hair dye lasts for a short period of time, it usually is a non-oxidative hair dyeing system. Okay, we call it as temporary hair dyeing system because of the time that it is present on the hair. It is present for a very short period of time. Itna short ki after you give a wash the second day, okay, in the first shampooing, the dye leaves your hair. Why does it happen? Because the dye consists of high molecular weight, what you call that? High molecular weight substances. Okay, the molecules are having high molecular weight. Okay, the dye is having high molecular weight, and it is acidic in nature. Because of this, we are going to see how alkaline agents are acting onto the hair further. But because of the acid characteristics and because of the high molecular weight, these dye, they do not penetrate through the cuticle, they do not pass through the cuticle, and they do not reach to the cortex. As they are not passing through the cuticle, as they are remaining on the cuticle, that is on the surface of the hair, hence, and there is no binding that is taking place between the dye molecule and the cuticle or the hair. As there is no bonding that is taking place, hence, after the first shampoo, this color they get fade off, they get removed. Okay. So it consists of high molecular weight dye and it is acidic in nature. These dyes are acidic in nature. Therefore, what happens is they deposit on the hair surface and they do not penetrate the cortex, which I told you. They are not penetrating into the cortex. They are not entering inside the cortex area. They are just remaining on the cuticle area. Okay. It does not have the power of whitening the hair strand. Okay. Alkaline usually substances, whenever they are used, whenever you are using H2O2, okay, whenever you are using H2O2, when you are using alkaline agent, okay, when these agents have been used, that we are going to see when we are going to see about the permanent hair dyes. Okay, now when these agents are used, what they do is they remove the color that is present onto the hair. Okay, so hair has its natural color, and that natural color is getting removed by H2O2 or your alkaline agent. Okay, this does not happen in case of the temporary hair dye. So it does not have the power of whitening the hair strand. It does not remove the natural color that is present on the hair strand. But what happens is these color, they get attached onto this cuticle. Okay, they are present onto the cuticle. They can be formulated in the form of shampoo, they are formulated in the form of hair gels, they are formulated in the form of emulsion, they are formulated in the form of solution. Also, aerosol cans, etc., are available, whereby you spray these colors onto your hair. Okay, so different formulations are available. They are basically used to give, brighter and more vibrant shade, basically for parties. Okay, these types of parties, shadi, ya fir when you are doing some act on the stage, etc., whereby you want the dye to remain for a very short period of time. Okay, That time these colors are basically used, and basically vibrant colors, bright colors are used in your temporary non-oxidative hair dyeing system. For example, orange, red, these types of colors have been used. Okay. Now, as I told you, the purpose is in order to have colorful reflection of your hair, in order to remove if there is some yellowish effect that is there onto the white effect of the hair, then in order to remove that, okay. Or you are covering a small quantity of white hair, you have a little bit of white hair, okay. So you want to cover that for a short period of time, okay. In that case, also you can go for a temporary non-oxidative hair dyeing system, which are where oxidative reaction does not take place, and these remain onto the hair for a very short period of time. That is only up to first shampooing, okay. So you shampoo, and these colors get removed. This is about the temporary non-oxidative hair dyeing color. Some of the examples we are going to see. Okay, some of the examples, if you take the international nomenclature of your cosmetic ingredient, that the colors that I use are acid yellow 23, you have acid orange 7, acid red 33, acid red 92, acid violet 43, acid blue 9, acid black 1. These are the chemical formula of these dyes which have been used. Okay, and this is the chemical classification. I'm not going to go more into the chemistry of it. Just if you want, you can, who has a very sharp memory, they can remember all this table. Others can just remember these, these simple two or three examples. Okay, these two three examples also it will be useful for you, okay, in order to write down the answers. Okay. Usually, you use combination of these. So you have an acid yellow 23 plus acid red 33 or acid violet 43 in combination. So you use two to five substances in combination in order to get a desired natural shade that you want for your hair. Okay. As you can see, it is acid. So it is exhibiting acidic characteristics. So these all are acidic in nature, right? Moving to the next type of hair dyeing system, you have the next type of hair dyeing system are semi-permanent. These are also non-oxidative hair dyeing system. Last, when we are going to see permanent hair dyeing system, that time you will be in a better position to understand the oxidative and non-oxidative hair dyeing system, what I mean to say. Okay. These are semi-permanent, whereas your temporary hair dyeing system, they last for one shampoo. If you take your semi-permanent hair dyeing system, they last for near about three to six washes. Okay. They are basic in nature, temporary or acidic in nature. These are basic in nature, or they are the cationic dyes. There are two types of dyes, basic dyes or cationic dyes. We are going to see the examples of both of them. And because it is having a high pH value, as it is basic, so it is going to have a high pH value. So, as it is having a high pH value, therefore, this cuticle opening, it takes place. A little bit of cuticle opening takes place. And as they are having low molecular weight as compared to a temporary one. So, as they are having low molecular weight as compared to the temporary one, secondly, it is basic in nature, so it is opening your cuticle also. Okay, it causes the swelling of the cuticle, and because of the swelling of the cuticle, swelling of the hair basically, and because of the swelling of the cuticle takes place, the openings openings are being created, and through these openings that is created in the cuticle, your dye it enters inside into to the cortex area. Okay, so the basic nature of it promotes the opening of the cuticle, and the low molecular mass that is there with your semi-permanent dye, they help in penetration inside the cortex area through the cuticle. Also, this semi-permanent hair dye has affinity for hair keratin. If you remember, I talked about keratin. If you remember, hair consists of keratin, and this keratin consists of disulfide bond. If you remember, I've told you earlier, right? So this keratin is nothing but the protein. So this, your hair is made up of large amount of keratin. And your semi-permanent hair dye has a large affinity towards hair keratin. Hence, as it has a large affinity towards hair keratin, that's why it gets attached, it gets bonded to the hair keratin. Because of all these reasons, whatever I have talked about earlier, because of the basic nature, because of the low molecular weight, because of the high affinity towards for the keratin, this semi-permanent non-oxidative hair dyeing system, they usually dry for 3 to 6 shampooing. Okay, so if you want to change the color of your hair for near about a week or say 10 days, 15 days, then you can go for semi-permanent non-oxidative hair dyeing system. These are more stronger, okay, and more permanent coloring system as compared to your temporary non-oxidative hair dyeing system. Please remember, they also do not involve oxidative reaction. Your temporary and semi-permanent, they do not involve oxidative reaction. Whereas if you take demi-permanent is a combination of your semi-permanent and oxidative system. Okay, so you have a little bit of semi-permanent hair dyes inside it, and you have some oxidative dyes that are also present inside your demi-permanent. Whereas if you take temporary and if you take semi-permanent, they do not contain any oxidation reaction that is not happening inside them. They can be formulated in the form of shampoo, lotions, okay, mousses or emulsions. They can be formulated in different form. Now they should have ideal viscosity. Any hair dyeing shampoo should have ideal viscosity so they do not flow during the application. So when you are applying, they should not flow off. Okay, hence ideal viscosity is very, very important. Dyes that are used over here are nitroamino phenols or amino anthraquinones. These types of dyes are being used in case of semi-permanent non-oxidative hair dyeing system. Some of the examples that you can see are if you see, there are nitroanilines that are used as semi-permanent hair dyes. Examples of nitroanilines which are used as semi-permanent hair dyes are yellow number 2. This is the empirical formula. This is the chemical classification. You will see most of them are nitroanilines. So this is nitroaniline. Okay, this is also nitroaniline. This is also nitroaniline. Okay, so they are basically nitroaniline in what you call that, structurally and with the regards to the molecular formula. So these are the different examples. You can remember a few examples of nitroaniline. You can use, remember, yellow number 2. You can use, remember, SC red number 3, SC blue number 2. Okay, these three examples you can remember. If you find these two to remember a little bit difficult, then you have another examples of semi-permanent dyes that are cationic dyes, which I talked about. Okay, the examples of cationic dyes, they include basic brown 17, basic brown 16, basic red 51, and basic red 76. These are some of the examples of your cationic dyes. Okay, these all they come under your semi-permanent hair dyeing system. Now moving ahead to your demi-permanent hair dyeing system. Now these demi-permanent, they usually resist up to 20 washes. So your temporary is for one wash, it gets removed. If you see your semi-permanent, they lie for near about 3 to 6 washes, and if you see your demi-permanent hair dye, they usually are retained up to near about 20 washes, right? So it is having the durability is little bit higher as compared to your semi-permanent dyes. They basically are, okay, these demi-permanent hair dyes, they are basically are mixture of your, as I told you earlier, they are mixture of semi-permanent permanent molecule, the molecules which you saw earlier, and they also consist of oxidation dye precursors, which you are going to see in our next slides in detail when you are going to see about the permanent hair dyes. So they are basically are combination of the both. They are combination of the semi-permanent also, and they also contain some oxidation dye precursors. Okay, and also hydrogen peroxide is been applied. Okay, is been added to this demi-permanent hair products. Now, whenever there are some oxidation dye precursors that are present, this oxidation, it basically involves the oxidation reaction, and this oxidation reaction takes place because of hydrogen peroxide. This hydrogen peroxide, it basically initiates the oxidation reaction. Okay, hence demi-permanent hair dye system, you cannot say that they are purely oxidative system, or you cannot say they are purely non-oxidative system. they are in between them because it has some semi-permanent molecules also which do not require oxidation, whereas it requires some dye precursors which in order to show its action require oxidation, and this oxidation is usually carried out with the help of hydrogen peroxide. Okay, am I clear up till here? Have you understood up till here? Any question you have, any problem you have, please do ask me. We are on to the hair dye systems. We are talking about the oxidative system and non-oxidative system. In non-oxidative system, we have talked about the temporary hair dyeing system, which lasts for very few days, where there is no entry of the molecules are very big molecular weight. They do not pass through the cuticle. They do not enter the cortex. There is no affinity that is there in between them, and hence they get removed. Then we talked about the semi-permanent hair dyeing system, which lasts for near about this is also non-oxidative type. They last for near about you can say 5 to 6 shampoos. Okay, they have affinity to keratin. They are basic in nature. That's why they cause swelling of the cuticle. Because of the swelling of the cuticle, there is opening, thereby they penetrate inside the through the cuticle, enter inside the cortex, and that is why they remain for a longer period of time. And then we talked about demi-permanent. We didn't write down when we wrote about demi-permanent, we didn't write down whether it is oxidative or non-oxidative, because it is the combination of both of them and it contains hydrogen peroxide. Am I clear up till here? Please. Am I clear? Have you understood everything? Any question you have? Somebody, if they can open the mic and tell me if I was clear. Have you understood everything up till now so that I can go further?
Sir, you are clear, sir.
Okay, then fine. So this up till now, this concept is clear. Now, these all we talked about the non-oxidative hair dyeing system. Our major focus when we are talking about is your permanent oxidative hair dyeing system. Okay. Now, permanent हेयर डाइंग सिस्टम दे आर रेजिस्टेंट टू शैम्पू वॉशेस. आप कितना भी शैम्पू करो, आप दे आर नॉट ओनली रेजिस्टेंट टू योर शैम्पू वॉशेस, दे आर रेजिस्टेंट टू ड्राइंग, दे आर रेजिस्टेंट टू फ्रिक्शन, दे आर रेजिस्टेंट टू लाइट. सो योर यूवी लाइट ऑल्सो डजेंट हैव एनी इफेक्ट ऑन इट. आप जो फ्रिक्शन करते हो, आप जो बाल पोछते हो अभी विथ योर वॉट कॉल दैट विथ योर टॉवेल्स एक्सेट्रा. ओके, सो दैट टाइम ऑल्सो विथ दैट फ्रिक्शन ऑल्सो फ्रिक्शन ऑफ योर कोम एक्सेट्रा, फॉर दैट ऑल्सो दे आर रेजिस्टेंट. इफ यू ड्राई इट विथ योर ड्रायर्स, ब्लोअर्स एक्सेट्रा, फॉर दैट ऑल्सो दे आर रेजिस्टेंट. दे डू नॉट गेट रिमूव फ्रॉम योर हेयर सरफेस. ओके, फ्रॉम योर क्यूटिकल दे गेट बाउंड टू इट बिकॉज दे एंटर इन साइड द कॉर्टेक्स. 80% ऑफ द हेयर डाइज दैट आर सोल्ड आर परमानेंट ऑक्सीडेटिव हेयर डाइंग सिस्टम. They basically are used in order to dye your gray hair. Okay. As I told you, it is a cosmetic because gray hair is a sign of old age. And if you see the cosmetics that are sold nowadays, highest quantity of cosmetics that have been sold are anti-aging preparation. Okay. Anti-aging preparations are very, very widely and highly sold. And the cost of these cosmetics are also very, very high because nobody wants to look old, right? So 80% of cosmetics, 80% of hair dyes system that are used are permanent oxidative hair dyeing system, whereas 20% are temporary, semi-permanent or demi-permanent hair dyeing system. Now, what does it contains? It is the combination of oxidizing agent. That's why it is oxidative hair dyeing system. So you have oxidizing agent. Oxidizing agent basically used is hydrogen peroxide. Okay, so hydrogen peroxide is used as an oxidizing agent along with an alkaline medium. So you have oxidizing agent, you have alkaline medium. Okay, alkaline medium usually used is ammonium hydroxide. Okay, so you have oxidizing agent, you have alkaline agent in the form of ammonium hydroxide or ammonia. What does this oxidizing agent do is, oxidizing agent basically, okay, if I get an opportunity to go to the next slide. Okay, So these are the primary intermediates. Your oxidizing agent basically oxidizes this primary intermediate so that they do a reaction with the coupling agent. So this is the role of the oxidizing agent. Whereas your alkaline medium, which is in the form of ammonium hydroxide, okay, which is in the form of monoethanol amine, okay, or ammonia as such, what does this alkaline medium basically do is they promote the environment, okay, which will facilitate oxidation reaction. One thing. Secondly, what do they do is they also promote the opening of this cuticle, as we talked about earlier also. Basically, if you remember when we talked about semi-permanent hairline system, alkaline medium or basic environment, what they promote is they cause the swelling of this cuticle. And as the swelling of this cuticle take place, hence there is opening that is taking place, which allows the dye molecule to penetrate into the cortex and in order to form a bond with the cortex. The alkaline medium, as I told you earlier, they are used are ammonia, ammonium hydroxide and ethanol amines. Why ammonia is not written over here? There is a specific reason, because ammonia is shown to have hazardous effect. And hence nowadays, non-ammonia containing hair dyes are basically being preferred. But ammonia is a very good alkaline medium and it was used for a very long period of time. Okay, up till for last two few years. Okay, ammonia containing hair dyes were very commonly being used. Nowadays with the newer hair dyes and with the problem that ammonia is having onto the hair shaft and onto the body also, that's why ammonia is not that much preferred. And now you have ammonia free hair dyes, which you'll be seeing inside the market. Okay, so ammonium hydroxide, ethanol amines, monoethanol amines, basically they have been used as alkalizing agent. You also surfactants can be added into it in order to disperse the dye molecule. You know, surfactants are very good, they disperse very nicely, so they are very used, very good as a dispersing agent. So they disperse the dye molecule and they also cause the responsible for wetting of the hair. Reducing agents are also been added. The role of reducing agent, you'll be in a better position to understand once I explain you the chemistry in my next few slides. Okay, so we have a special slide for reducing agent. At that time I will be explaining you how these reducing agents are helpful in your formulation. They basically prevent the auto oxidation of the dyes during the finished product storage. This sentence I will be explaining you in detail in my last slide. Okay, they can be formulated as emulsions, gels, solutions and powders. They can be present in different form. Emulsion form is the most emulsion and powder form are the most formulation that are available inside the market. Okay, also gels and solutions sometimes maybe they might be present in that form also. Now let us go to this poster is a very good poster. I have liked this poster a lot, and this poster I have taken, this is the reference from where I have taken this poster. It is very nicely prepared. It explains you the permanent hair dye system in just one slide. Okay, so what does this permanent hair dye system consist of? It basically consists of the formulation aspect. If you talk about this hair dyeing system, it basically consists of primary intermediates. Okay, this is the first compound that is present. These primary intermediates are also known as coupling bases. Okay, so it consists of primary intermediates or coupling bases. These primary intermediates, they are just for an example. If you take the examples, one of the examples is paraphenylene diamine. Okay, paraphenylene diamine, if you take, if you see, there are two amine groups and these two amine groups are attached at para position. Just to make you remember this compound, I'm just breaking it down. I'm just telling the chemistry of it. Okay, so you have two amine groups which are there at the para position. Okay, why I'm telling you para position also, it will be clear when I talk after some few minutes. Okay, so it consists of two amine groups at the para position and hence it is paraphenylene diamine on a benzene ring. Okay, you have two amine group at para position. And the second compound that is being used as an intermediate dye is para aminophenol. So it is a phenol. If you can see, this is a phenol, and again your amino group is present on at the para position here, over here also. Okay, so these are the two widely used primary intermediates. These primary intermediates basically undergoes oxidation in the presence of your H2O2. Okay, they are oxidized by a hydrogen peroxide and they form the reactive species. These reactive species, they react with the coupling agents. If you see the coupling agents, they basically contains your molecules, okay, the attachments at the ortho position. Okay, if you see, they both are present at ortho position. If you see over here, they are present at ortho position. This is ortho position. Okay, this is para position. Okay, this is an ortho position. Okay, this is an ortho position again. So mostly they have the compounds which are present on the ortho position, right? So that's why I was saying about the para position and ortho position, and these are the coupling agent. So your primary intermediates, they undergo oxidation, they form an intermediate, and these intermediate, and hence they are known as primary intermediate, because the molecule undergo oxidation and form an intermediate. Okay, and they then react with this coupling agent in the presence of this alkaline agent. So this hydrogen peroxide that is present over here, this is basically what, this is acting as an oxidizing agent. It oxidizes this primary intermediates. Then you have alkaline agents. So you have ammonia as one of the alkaline agents. You have ethanol amine as one of the alkaline agents. These alkaline agents, they provide the environment for reaction, for oxidation, as well as the reaction of this primary intermediate along with the coupling agent. I also told you this alkaline agent is are helpful in opening the cuticle also, isn't it? So that the dyes can penetrate inside. So they are helpful in that also. So you have now three ingredients that we have talked about. We have talked about the primary intermediates, which are known as coupling bases. We have talked about the other compound, which are alkalizing compound and also oxidating compounds. Okay, for example, H2O2 and ammonia and ethanolamine, and you have coupling agents. These primary intermediates and these coupling agent, also known as couplers, they basically react in order to give a dye. And this dye, when you apply onto the hair, it makes your hair colorful. Maybe red, maybe magenta, maybe brown, maybe black, or maybe different colors can be given to your hair. So this is the reaction that takes place. You have a primary intermediate, which is this. You have a coupling agent over here in the presence of alkalizing compound. So these are the alkalizing compound, and in the presence of oxidizing compound, that is H2O2, what they form is a dye. And this dye is applied onto your hair in order to make it colorful, maybe black or maybe some other color. This is the basic chemistry of your hair dye. Okay, again, the same thing I will be repeating for you so that it will be in a better, you will be in a better position to understand. Okay, the first compound that you are using is primary intermediate, which I talked about, which are also known as coupling bases. They are basically aromatic compound. So this is the aromatic compound that is there, that is derived from benzene. Okay, so you have a benzene structure and you have aromatic compound. It consists of two electron donor groups, that is NH2. In this case, NH2, NH2, NH2. So you have two electron donor groups, that is NH2 and OH, and they are basically present in the para or ortho position, but basically they are over here, they are both present in the para position. Okay, they undergo easy oxidation and they act as a color developer. Okay, these undergo easy oxidation, whereas if you see the next compound, okay, that we are going to see, okay, over here, the coupling compounds, they do not undergo easy oxidation. These do not undergo easy oxidation. Whereas if you see these compound, they undergo easy oxidation. So H2O2 that you are adding, okay, this H2O2 is going to basically and what you call that, undergo oxidation. They will oxidize this compound, okay, that is paraphenylene diamine PPD or paraaminophenol, okay, PAP. So these compounds, they are going to basically oxidize, so they undergo easy oxidation and act as color developer. Two major compounds which I told you already, that is paraphenylene diamine and paraaminophenol, they can be used as primary intermediate. They react with hydrogen peroxide. These two compounds react with hydrogen peroxide and give reactive species, intermediate species, which then react with the coupler to produce a dye. Reactions we have already seen over here, right? Moving ahead, second compound we talked about are the alkalizing agent. So these two are the alkalizing agent, that is ammonia and ethylene diamine. Hydrogen peroxide, please remember, it is not an alkalizing agent. It is a oxidating agent. Okay, it causes the oxidation reaction. So these two basically, okay, if you see these two, they are basically the alkalizing agent, what you are talking about over here. It basically provides the proper pH for beginning of the oxidation reaction and also for the formation of the dye. So dye formation reaction जो आपका होता है उसके लिए भी, and for the oxidative reaction उसके लिए भी this hydrogen peroxide is very very useful. Okay, alkalizing agent basically ammonia, ammonium hydroxide or monoethanol amine. Ammonia, it also helps to cover your 100% of the white hair. Okay, because it removes the natural pigment, fluomelanin, melanin, okay, whatever is present, it helps to remove that. Okay, your hair contains natural pigment. Okay, these natural pigments are known as melanins. So melanins may be present basically whenever your hairs are black in color, then the natural dye that is present is melanin. Indians, we have a lot of melanin. Then you have another hair dye, another natural dye that is present, that is eumelanin. Okay, that is eumelanin, eumelanin. Okay, that is over here, you can see over here, fine. So you have melanin, then you have eumelanin, and the third one is pheomelanin. This eumelanin, they basically give your hair, if I'm not wrong, I may be mistaking also, it basically gives the brown color to your hair, eumelanin. Okay, so the brown color is because of eumelanin. But and if you take your pheomelanin basically gives the red color. Okay, those red hair you see in many individuals, that is because of the presence of pheomelanin. So these are the natural dyes that are present onto the inside the hair, okay, on the in the hair, which gives it color. Your ammonia also, and also your hydrogen peroxide for that matter, now please remember that also, what they do is they remove this natural pigment. So whatever new color that you are adding, okay, that new color takes the place of your natural pigment. Okay, another example of alkaline agent that is present is monoethanolamine, that is MEE. It basically is nowadays widely used because it provides optimum alkaline pH. Okay, and whereas it does not oxidizes your melanin also. Okay, so your natural color is maintained. Okay, and that is why this monoethanolamine is nowadays widely used. As I said, that ammonia nowadays is been banned in your hair colors, right? And you have ammonia-free hair dyes nowadays. So monoethanolamine or ammonium hydroxide, these can be used, or you can use other alkaline agents also, which are devoid of ammonia. Okay, those are also been used nowadays, right? When you are adding monoethanolamine, basically they are helpful in maintaining the similar shade, or they are able to maintain your dark hair, because the pigments, okay, the natural pigments, they are not removed from your hair. So this is about the alkalizing compounds that have been used. Going further to the next compounds are the reaction modifiers or the coupling agent. Now, as I talked about, some of the examples are resorcinol, meta-aminophenol, then 2-methyl-5-aminophenols, which is known as magenta. You have light brown, you have greenish yellow, you have dark brown shades, You have purple blue shades, you have blue violet shades, green shades, dark blue. They basically give these shades after the reaction. Okay. These basically are the aromatic, these are also the aromatic compound, as you can see. Okay. And they are also contains basically the NH2 group and OH group, as was contains in your, as was present in your primary intermediates. They also contains NH2 and OH group, but NH2 and OH, they are basically present at the meta position. Sorry, I told you the ortho position. They are basically present at the meta position. Okay. And they do not basically they do not one of the things that they do not undergo oxidation. Your primary intermediates, they undergo oxidation, but these compounds, they do not undergo easy oxidation. And the next thing that is important over here, they do not produce the color alone. Whenever they react with the intermediates, that is the time they are going to produce the color, otherwise they are not going to produce the color. Once again, to tell you about the reaction, you have primary intermediate which I started with. So you have the primary intermediate. You'll be in a better position now to understand what is the primary intermediate. You have a coupling agents. These are the coupling agents. You have the primary intermediates. You have alkalizing compound in the form of ammonia, okay? And you have some alkalizing some hair dyes which are now ammonia free also. So you add some alkalizing compound, add some oxidizing agents, okay, in the form of H2O2, which reacts with your primary intermediate to form an intermediate, okay, which reacts further reacts with your coupling agent, and finally there is a formation of a dye. You want to see the actual reaction, how it takes place? Let us see one of the reactions over here. This is the primary intermediate PPD, okay, paraphenylene diamine. This you are reacting with resorcinol. You are adding H2O2. When you add H2O2, oxidation takes place. Oxidation takes place, and when the oxidation reaction takes place, H2 is removed from here. If you see the reaction, from here the H2 is getting removed. From here, H is getting removed. So these are the two molecules. This is one molecule of PPD, and this is the second molecule of PPD. These two molecules of PPD, it causes a loss of hydrogen over here. There is loss of two hydrogen over here. There is loss of one hydrogen, and then it reacts with the molecule of resorcinol. So it is reacting with the molecule of resorcinol, and it is forming a dye that is green indole dye. It is not necessary for you to remember the reaction. We are trying to study pharmaceutics over here. But in order to make you write your theory in a more better way, I'm just trying to show you this reaction. Even if you don't remember this reaction, even if you don't remember the structure, please don't worry. Okay. Once again, I'm telling you, in order to make you understand the theoretical part, okay, I'm just trying to show you this reaction. So here you have PPD. Again, there are two molecules of PPD. Again, the one two molecules of hydrogen are removed over from here. One molecule of hydrogen is removed from here, and your aminophenol, okay, meta-aminophenol is being attached over to this molecules of PPD. You have another molecule of PPD. Here only one molecule of PPD is reacting. In this cases, two molecules were there. In this case, only one molecule of PPD is reacting. Undergoes oxidation, hydrogen is getting removed, and this magenta color, okay, is getting added to it, and it is forming a dye. So this is the final dye that is getting formed. I don't know how many of you have seen the preparation of this hair dye. Okay, you are quite young, so maybe you must have not seen how these hair dyes are prepared. But it consists of two pouches basically. It consists of one pouch which consists of your primary intermediate, okay, and it consists of other pouch which is consisting of this coupling agent. This coupling agent many a times consists of your hydrogen peroxide, okay, because they do not undergo easy oxidation. When you react this primary, when you react you when you take this one pouch and you mix with this second pouch. This second pouch is containing hydrogen peroxide. It forms a reaction. It forms oxidation reaction, and then it reacts with this coupling agent that is present over here, and then it gives the diformation. Okay, so this reaction is usually getting formed, right? Now coming to my earlier point, which I talked about, if you remember, I said when I was talking about this slide, I said that it consists of reducing agent also, and I said that I will explain you in detail how this reducing agent is acting, if you remember, right? So let us see how these reducing agents are acting. Basically, this reducing agent do not allow the oxidation reaction to take place when these coupling agents and primary intermediates are present together. Okay, so you don't want the reaction to happen, okay, inside when the storage is been taking place, but you want the reaction to happen before the application, okay, of the hair dye to your hair, right? So in order to prevent, otherwise if this reducing agent is not been present, then what is going to happen? This reaction between the primary intermediate and the coupling agent is going to take place, okay, and the dye formation is going to happen. But we want the dye formation to happen just before the, what you call that, just before the application of the hair dye. Hence, what you are adding is reducing agent. This reducing agent, just for an example of sodium metabisulfite, just we have taken one of the example as sodium metabisulfite. This sodium metabisulfite prevents this reaction between primary intermediate and coupling agent during the storage. Okay, so during the storage, this reaction is being prevented, okay, with the help of this reducing agent. I hope you have understood the importance of reducing agent. There are some dyes, okay, there are in many a cases, in order to prevent this reaction, okay, many a times, as I told you, these two are packed separately. So you have tube number one, you have tube number two. And when you are preparing the dye, you take a bowl, you add your tube number one, you add your tube number two, and then you mix them together. Okay, then you cause mixing of them together and the dye formation takes place. Okay, so that is how it is taking place. But reducing agents are added so that this reaction, that is the dye formation, does not take place inside the pack only if these two are present in the same pouch. Okay, as a powder or as an emulsion or as a lotion or as a cream, if they are present in the same pouch, okay, in the same tube, then the reaction should not take place. For that, you are adding reducing agents. Okay, we have talked in deep about the oxidants. Okay, very much, that is about the hydrogen peroxide. Hydrogen peroxide is basically used when the vehicle is water. Okay. Hydrogen peroxide is very unstable, okay, and hence whenever you are using hydrogen peroxide in order to cause oxidation reaction of your primary intermediates, okay, that time stabilizers such as sodium tannate, pentasodium pentate, these are basically used as a stabilizing agent because hydrogen peroxide is very unstable in nature. Okay, then sodium persulfate can also be used as an oxidant, okay, instead of hydrogen peroxide when the formulation is in the form of powders. Okay, so hydrogen peroxide, sodium persulfate, these can be used as an oxidants, right? Now the last compound and the last thing that has been used are the bases. Okay, now all these have to whatever things we have seen, that is the reducing agent, the oxidizing agent, the primary intermediates, the coupling agent, okay, they all have to go in a base, isn't it? They all have to be added in a base. So bases can be used. These bases, they consist of water, ethanol, ethyl alcohol, glycerin. They can be in the form of emulsion. When you are prepared, they can be in the form of, when they are in the form of emulsion, they can be in the form of cream or lotions, okay. We have already talked about cream. Creams are usually water in oil or oil in water type of emulsion. Similarly, lotions, we have not talked about lotions. Lotions are also usually oil in water type of an emulsion. Whenever you are preparing a lotion, if you are writing the formula for lotion, or if you are preparing a lotion, then you will see that basically it consists of cetosterol alcohol inside it. They are basically emulsified by cetosterol alcohol. Whenever you are preparing lotion, you will see that. And emulsion again are of two types. You have foaming type creams and you have non-foaming type creams also. If you are preparing a dye, if you are mixing a dye and if you find that the foam is being produced, then they are foam type creams. If you see that no foam is being produced, then they are non-foaming type creams. When you are mixing the preparation, बेसिकली हेयर डाई एक्सेट्रा या फिर आप कोई भी चीज अगर आप मिक्स करोगे और उसमें से फोम अगर जनरेट होता है सो दीज आर बेसिकली फोमिंग टाइप क्रीम्स. ओके सो दीज आर बेसिकली द बेसिस विच आर यूज इन ऑर्डर टू एड योर कपलिंग बेसिस, इन ऑर्डर टू एड योर कपलिंग एजेंट्स, इन ऑर्डर टू एड योर अल्कलाइजिंग कंपाउंड एंड एंटी ऑक्सीडेंट एंड ऑल्सो फॉर दैट मैटर रिड्यूसिंग एजेंट्स. ओके सो बेसिस आर बीन यूज इन विच यू शेड एड दिस. And finally, you should mix them together in order to form a dye. Okay. This is one of the formula that I have taken. Okay. So if you see that most of the compounds that we have talked about are present over here, that's why I have taken this. It consists of colorant, which is made up of paraphenylene diamine. This we have talked about. It consists of aminophenol. This also we have talked about. It consists of metaphenylene diamine. This is para as well as metaphenylene diamine. Okay. And it also consists of resorcinol, the first compound that we have seen in the chart. Okay. So these are the colorants that have been used. Oxidant that is used over here is hydrogen dioxide, that is hydrogen peroxide. H2O2 is being used as 35%. Okay. So these are the ingredients that are present inside. This is the formulation of your hair dye.